Hello, good morning, family. I want to welcome you to today's inspirational vitamin. This comes from Mark chapter 10. We're going to start off in verse 17. And I believe we're going to go all the way down to verse 22. And it says, as Jesus started on his way, a man ran up to him and fell on his knees before him. Good teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Why do you call me good? Jesus answered. No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony. You shall not defraud and honor your father and mother. Teacher, he declared, all of these I have kept since I was a boy. Jesus looked at him and loved him. One thing you lack, he said, go sell everything you have and give it to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. At this, the man's face fell. He went away sad because he had great wealth. And I read this scripture and it really hit home for me because for a long time in my walk with God, I thought, you know, this is this guy, he's just there to try to justify himself, you know, and get Jesus to say, you know, well, you're doing a great job, pat on the back, good job, or whatever. But that really, when I read it, I didn't get that perception for a number of different reasons here. The first being, when he came to Jesus, it didn't seem, he ran up to him and fell on his knees. So there was an urgency and a humility that was there from him. Also, it says that Jesus looked at him and loved him. And so Jesus, he didn't sense any pride or arrogance in what the man was trying to do. And so those are some of the main things, main points. And then when the man was told what to do, it says he went away sad. You know, so he genuinely wanted to do what was right. But the thing that I mainly want to talk about today, we have that question today, you know, as disciples of Jesus, we already have eternal life, right? But there are other things that we're asking, what must I do for? Let me explain that. He said, what must I do to inherit eternal life? So what are we asking? What must I do to get rid of sin that keeps plaguing me? What must I do to spark a fire in my marriage again? What must I do to get married? What must I do to get my life group motivated? And a lot of us, we may think about our children or our neighbors or our coworkers, and we may say, man, what must I do in order for them to become a Christian? The thing is this, God will potentially do any of those things in our life based on his will. But the true question is, have you given up everything? And that was the thing with this rich young ruler, is that he had not given up everything for what he had a desire to get. And have you done everything that you can to be what you need to be in that particular situation? In my spiritual walk, there have been good lines that I haven't crossed. Fasting was one of the things that was my treasures. The thing that I wouldn't give up was food, you know, in order to get more close to God or to improve my marriage. Sacrifice, like true sacrifice of sleep, of my time and energy, were things that I would not give up at one point in my walk. And so I want to encourage us as we move forward, as we ask that question about these different areas in our life, what do I need to do? What must I do to fill in the blank? Let's think about what have we not done to obtain those things. And then when we do those things, then let's pray to God. Let's be praying to God about those things and making sure that we're not trusting in what we're doing, but we're trusting in Him. And I think that faith and those deeds will work hand in hand. Y'all have a great weekend. Love you.